Eclipses are intimately tied into the history of astronomy and science. It's sort of a triumph of exact science and mathematical science that it's become possible over the course of 3,000 years of work to predict when an eclipse will arrive to within a second or two. Eclipse prediction is a giant kind of geometry exercise. But the real thing that had to be solved for eclipses was the three-body problem of the motion of the Earth, Moon, and Sun. What do you actually have to work out to know when the eclipse is going to happen?
Ancient astronomers saw three periodic cycles hidden in the movements of the moon. They noticed it takes 29.5 days to go from one new moon to the next. This full lunar phase cycle is known as the synodic month. They also saw that the sun and the moon are confined to two different paths in the sky. That's because of a cosmic quirk. The moon's orbit is tilted at 5 degrees above the Earth's orbit around the sun, known as the plane of the ecliptic. Every 27.2 days, the draconic month, the moon passes through the plane of the ecliptic at two different nodes. Finally, ancient astronomers observed that the moon appears closer and further away, returning to the same size in the sky every 27.5 days. This is the anomalistic month, caused by the moon's elliptical orbit. Armed with centuries of data, the Babylonians noticed something striking. Every 6,585 days and 8 hours, which is about 18 years, these cycles sync up, and this happens. This number came to be known as the Saros, a harmonic separating two eclipses.
After a Saros length of time, the geometry of the Sun-Earth-Moon system repeats again. The Babylonians realized that in 223 repetitions of the lunar phase cycle, you would have 239 repetitions in the apparent size of the moon oscillating, and 242 plunges through the plane of the ecliptic. All of these roughly equal the same amount of time.
That coincidence is what leads to these Saros cycles. Every Saros cycle, the position of the moon, the Earth and the Sun, and relative to the plane of the ecliptic, is sort of in the same configuration. That's what produces an eclipse.